Today, I want to share with you what's probably the best Photoshop extension panel that you've never heard of. As a landscape photographer, something that I tend to use quite frequently in Photoshop are luminosity masks. And luminosity masks allow you to target different areas of your image based on how bright or dark those areas are. So if you look at this image, for example, I may want to target this dark area here and increase the saturation, increase the contrast in it to make the colour stand out. Some of the light areas, for example, though, they may be a little bit too bright and prevent you from seeing the detail in them, so you may want to reduce those. Now, the problem with luminosity masks is that they're not really easy to create. Let me show you what I mean. If I go to the channels window and I want to create my first mask, I could hold down my command key and click on the RGB channel. And that will load the luminance values of that channel as a selection. And I can then save that as a new channel. And here we have Alpha 1. If I want to create a mask now that targets even lighter areas but ignores the other areas, I have to now create a new mask from this. And I can do that by holding down Shift, Alt and Command and clicking on that channel. This time if I save it, you'll see that the areas that in the previous mask were quite sort of mid-tone are now darker, meaning that they're not selected. And I can continue that process. So each time I'm creating a mask that targets a lighter and lighter areas in the image. If I want to go and target darker areas, I have to create a new series of masks. So let's go back to the first mask I created and we'll load that again. And this time I need to create a new mask from it. I'm going to invert it and immediately I've done it wrong. I've created a problem because I didn't remove my selection at the start. So I'm going to have to go back and undo that. And now I'll remove my selection. Then I can actually invert it. And now I can start the process again. And so each of these masks will target different areas of the image, depending on their tones. And that is a set of luminosity masks. And as you've seen, it's very easy to make mistakes. Now you can remove some of that by creating actions that will automate it. But that leaves you with another problem. You've got all these channels that exist then in the image, and they all add size and bloat to the image files. The alternative approach to creating masks is one of creating them on the fly. You create the mask that you need as you need it. And this is where this new piece of software comes in. It's called Mask Equalizer. It has a series of sliders that represent the tonal range from darks through to lights. And then you've got these sliders that you can move up and down. Now as you move them up and down, what you're doing is you're creating a mask. So here I've got a selection of the very darkest tones in the image and also the ones that are almost as dark. And as I'm moving these sliders around, it's creating a mask for me on the fly. And you can see that here the darkest tones are now black and the lighter tones are white in the mask. Now that's probably the reverse of what we want for selecting these areas here and this area. But all we have to do is click on our mask and use the properties window and invert it. And now we've got a selection of the very darkest areas in our image. Now let me just load that mask. Now when I add a new adjustment, the mask is now added to that adjustment. And now I can actually target adjustments onto the areas that we were looking at. Now the darkest areas of the image have now got this very strong contrast adjustment that I've applied to them. So you can see that the area here has become intensely red and contrasted because of the adjustment in the curves layer. And the same's also happened to them, the foreground here, which now appears sharper. And it really is as simple as that. If I find that I want a different mask, I can go back, delete my mask, and now I can go back to my mask equalizer, and this time I could use maybe different selections here. And I'll use that to select the lighter areas of the image. And then we can target those with an adjustment as well. Now the thing is, I don't have to just use the luminosity values. It gives me access to go for the red, green, blue, or even saturation of the image, and that will allow me to create these masks. And you can turn a mask preview on or off as you're creating them, as well as turn on the effect or turn off the effect. Now you don't even have to use the sliders individually as I have here. You can go for one of these presets. So we've got the shadows, we've got the midtones, we've got the highlights, or we've got the very useful shadows and highlights. And of course, once you've created one of these masks, you can either use it like that, or you can go to your properties window for the mask, and then you can invert it. And you can feather it, and you can change the density. Interestingly though, the mask equalizer itself will actually also give you some of those features. If I pull down here, you can see we've got the ability to adjust the contrast of the mask. And we've got a feather option. And we can reduce the density of the mask. So a lot of these things are easily available in that very, very simple interface. And that's what I really like about this. It's a simple interface that gives you access to very, very powerful masking features straight away. You don't have to go through the complicated process of creating masks or have lots and lots of masks in your channels window. You only have the mask that you're actually working on. Personally, I find this a great improvement over creating all those luminosity masks and channels, and the ability to target individual tones in this way is very, very flexible and powerful. And if you want to know the company that's behind this mask equalizer, I'll put the details down below in the information. I'll also stress that I'm in no way connected to the company, and I've paid for and bought this software myself. I actually bought it as part of a bundle, didn't think I was going to need this masking tool, and when I tried it, I was simply blown away by how useful it was. I hope you found this interesting. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next week for another video.